brand owners are looking at. Another one would be they are talking about, especially in the supply chain world, is this idea of packing their goods into what we call roll cages. So chances are it will still come out as a shipper carton from the manufacturer, but when it goes to the warehouse at the point of distribution, these products are then packed into what we call roll cages. So roll cages are easy to be transported to the site of the retail area, and as well as they are easily shelved for the purpose to minimize handling. So again, the whole idea is their primary two reasons. Number one, to minimize handling, and number two is also to reduce the head count of contact that is needed to shelf these materials or these products at the end of the journey, right? So these are primary two things that is being pushed very strongly in the industry. Now, as for relations to these innovations that bring about Industry 4.0, so one key area to talk about is actually how can they actually have better data points to determine where would be the best ideal location to shelf as well as to deliver. So this idea of on-demand delivery becomes more and more important. And as an industry as a whole, what we call the last mile delivery in the supply chain still remains a big challenge in Malaysia. So more and more brand owners are trying to invest into technology, into gathering how can we maximize and optimize a delivery route using technology, and this capturing data, traffic data, weather data, road conditions data, all in play with all the devices or IoT devices that's being installed either in the trucks, the delivery trucks itself, or even into the packaging that able to give them data. So this is one big area of importance. So I feel that as a result of that, our graduates in the food industry should have some basic knowledge of what IoT as well as data analytics is, because in a way, if they are going to move out into the supply chain world, especially in the food industry, these are some of the big questions that they need to face and address the same. The other portion, which has a very big analytics play, huge potential, but as a result in Malaysia, not so matured yet, is this idea of demand planning. So demand planning is actually the start of all supply chain, because dictates what the consumer needs, and that puts into motion of what type of production or manufacturing capabilities are needed to produce the product to meet the demand. However, with the FMCG world, the fast moving consumer goods world in Malaysia, most brand owners have moved into what we call a distribution model. Most brand owners no longer distribute their products themselves. They have appointed a third party to do that. And in this third party case, there's always what we call service level agreements on what they need to manage and deliver. If not, their fees will be severely penalized. So as a result of that, it creates a condition what we call controlled demand rather than actual demand. In a more matured markets like in the Western world, they are really using data analytics to actually capture actual data at the point of sales, or even they run loyalty programs at the retail store to determine what type of SKUs are very popular, and that dictates the daily or monthly supply chain work. But in Malaysia, because we still have this intermediary of a third party, the third party a lot of times may push a certain demand to meet their KPIs in order to enjoy the incentive. So as a result of that, it may not be an actual demand. But in moving forward, I think as competition become more and more intense, this demand planning will rely more so on the data driven by the consumers. And there's also the entire play of big data, especially from all these unstructured, unconventional sources such as social media, because that also will also help them to facilitate a model to predict what is the need for the consumer, hence improving efficiency and productivity in the supply chain.